In the last lecture, we have discussed classical sets and their properties. Now, we'll discuss the concept of fuzzy set. Now, before I just start with the concept of fuzzy set, let me try to spend some time to just understand why we need the concept of this particular fuzzy sets. Now, if you see the real world problems, which are very complex and difficult, and these are associated with some sort of imprecisions and uncertainties. Prior to the year 1965, people used to believe that it is the probability theory which can tackle the different types of uncertainties in this world. But in the year 1965, Professor L.A. Jaddae of the University of California, USA, told that there are many uncertainties in this particular world, and the probability theory can handle only one out of different uncertainties. And there are few uncertainties which cannot be tackled using the particular probability theory, which works based on the classical set or crisp set. Professor Jaddae argued that we need something which is at the higher level compared to the classical set. If you want to represent the different types of uncertainties or the imprecision which we face in the real world problems. Now let me take a very simple example, very practical example. Supposing that one of your friends is going to market and you are requesting him, please bring 1 kg red apple for me. And supposing that your friend has got the particular apple from the market, and there is a probability associated with the availability of apple, and it depends on the season. Now, there is an uncertainty regarding the availability of apple. And this particular uncertainty can be handled using the principle of probability theory, and the probability of getting apple varies from 0 to 1. Suppose that is 0.6. So with the probability of 0.6, your friend has got some apples. Fine. Now my next query, what is the guarantee that this particular apple is red? How can you define the color red? And the definition of this particular color red will vary from person to person. Now this problem has to be tackled, which is an uncertainty regarding the guarantee of the color of apple is red. So this particular uncertainty cannot be answered using the probability theory or classical or crisp set. To answer that, we have to go for another set that is nothing but fuzzy set. Now the same example which I took, let me just represent here. The color of this particular apple is red. According to classical set or crisp set, there are only two possibilities. One is apple will be red or it will not be red. So there are two answers. One is yes, another is no. If the apple is found to be red, then the characteristics value is 1.0. If the apple is not red, then its characteristics value is 0.0 in classical set or crisp set. So there are only two answers in classical set or crisp set. One is member or non-member. That means if it is member, the characteristics value is 1.0. If it is not, then it is 0.0. But the same color red will be defined in a slightly different way in fuzzy set. For example, the color red can be perfectly red, and the same color some other person may say this is almost red, and some other person will say this is slightly red, and there could be a possibility that it may not be called red also. So if it is perfectly red, then we assign a membership function value 1.0. Then it is called, it is perfectly red, then we assign a membership value of 1.0, and if it is almost red, then it is also called as red with a membership value of 0.8. If it is slightly red, then again it is also called as red with a membership value of 0.4. And if it is not at all red, then it is also called as red with the membership value is equal to 0. This is how we represent this kind of uncertainty using fuzzy sets. That is why the fuzzy sets has gained some popularity. Now come to the representation of a fuzzy set. The representation of fuzzy set will be represented as A of x is equal to x comma mu A of x, where x belong to the universal set capital X. That means if you want to represent the fuzzy set, we have to take the help of membership value which varies from 0 to 1. And if you remember, the probability value that will also vary from 0 to 1, but truly speaking, the concept of probability and the concept of membership are not exactly the same. So by probability, we mean it is the frequency of likelihood that an element in a class. That means your probability is related to the frequency data. On the other hand, membership is nothing but the similarity of an element to a class, to a particular class. For example, if I take the probability of getting apple, so that it will vary from 0 to 1, and what is the guarantee that the apple is red? It has got some membership value lying between 0 and 1. Now if I compare these two uncertainties, one is related to the availability of apple, another is related to the color of the particular apple. So these two uncertainties are not exactly the same, and there is a difference. Now the availability of apple, that will be handled by probability, but the guarantee whether this apple is red or not is indicated by the membership function value. This is how we represent the fuzzy sets. Now if you see the literature, we have got two types of fuzzy sets. One is called discrete fuzzy set and another is called continuous fuzzy set. Let us discuss the first one, that is discrete fuzzy set, which is represented by A of x is equal to sigma I is equal to 1 to n mu A of xi bar xi. Now remember, this particular symbol bar does not indicate the division, and the particular symbol sigma does not indicate the actual summation. They indicate the collection of data. The collection of this membership function value is indicated in this form. The small n indicates the number of elements in that particular set. Now I am just going to define the concept of this discrete fuzzy set with the help of an example. Consider this figure, which is indicating the temperature of a particular place during the first 15 days of a month. which is termed as moderate temperature. Now on first day it has got some temperature called with moderate temperature with the membership function of 0.15. On second day it has got another temperature value that is also called moderate with 0.2 membership value, and so on. This membership value mu varies from 0 to 1. Similarly, for all 15 days we can represent the temperature that is medium with the different values of membership. That is represented here with the help of a fuzzy set. That fuzzy set A of x is equal to 0.15 by day 1 plus 0.2 by day 2, so on, where 0.15 or 0.2 indicates the membership value mu of that particular day, and it can also be represented as A of x is equal to a collection of 1, 0.5, which is corresponding to day 1, which is x, mu of x of day 1, day 2, so on. This is how to represent the particular discrete type of fuzzy sets. Now if you look into the previous one, the continuous fuzzy set, which is indicated as A of x is equal to integration of x, A of x is equal to integration mu of x by x, and once again this integration is not indicating the true integration, and this is actually indicating the continuous fuzzy set that we'll discuss in the next slide. To concentrate on the concept of continuous fuzzy set, you can see the two diagrams there. They represent the different types of continuous fuzzy sets. In the previous diagram we have seen discrete fuzzy set, which will be available at one particular interval, not in between the interval, but here it is continuous. And in case of continuous fuzzy sets, there are two types of fuzzy sets. One is convex membership distribution fuzzy set, and another is non-convex membership distribution. So if you look at the first one, if there is increment in the membership value and there is attainment of maximum membership value, that is 1.0, and again decreasing. In the case of the second one, the membership distribution is increasing from 0 to 1 and falls from 1 to 0.5. Again remains at 0.5 for some time, again increases, again decreases. So if you look at the two diagrams represent the continuous fuzzy set, but the first one represents the convex fuzzy set, which satisfies the above relation, that mu a of lambda x1 plus 1 minus lambda x2 is greater than or equal to minimum of mu a of x1 comma mu a of x2. These will be discussed in the upcoming lectures, but the conclusion is the first diagram will satisfy the above condition. The second diagram may not satisfy the above condition. The first one is called convex membership function distribution of a fuzzy set, and second one is a fuzzy set with non-convex membership function distribution. We'll continue our discussion in the next class. Thank you.